Hey guys, so today I'm doing a makeup video. I am as surprised as you are, it's been a minute. And today I'm gonna be doing a makeup video on a duo of the makeup that I actually wore in my Q&A that I did recently. If you guys missed that video, I'm gonna link it up here, but I did a pregnancy Q&A because I'm pregnant. I'm never gonna quit being shocked by that, but I'm not gonna be talking a ton about that in this video, okay? Like, I know some people are probably like, bitch, shut up. And I'm like, okay, well, don't tell me what to do because you're not my robot. Today I'm gonna be doing my makeup like I did in that video. So many people are like, you're glowing. And I do need you to know that it was just the makeup. I really don't feel like I'm glowing. I'm wearing no makeup right now, and truly, I need it. I have been wearing less foundation on my face recently, just really trying to like put it right where I need it, not coating my entire face and then really highlighting my face. I actually really liked the way that my highlighter looked the other day. It was really intense in that video, but I used actually the Jaclyn Cosmetics highlighters. So if you guys didn't get those, I'll try to like figure out some close dupes-ish, but they're actually so nice. They're beautiful. If you guys ever missed that video that I did on them, I'm gonna link it up here. A lot of people may not have them given that it was a limited edition launch, but I have them and I have been using them recently when I want that like really intense bright glow. Ofra highlighters are absolutely beautiful. Hourglass has amazing highlighters. There's just so many good ones out there that honestly you don't need to use these ones, but that's what I used. I've been doing very minimal eye makeup lately, kind of focusing on having like really glowy skin. And then, you know, I told you guys, but I'm really liking this whole just my natural lashes with mascara thing. I'm loving lashes. I wore them the other day and I felt so pretty when I wore lashes. But on the everyday recently, I am so tired and I'm so out of it. And so when I want to feel really put together and pretty, I'm typically just doing like a very quick, easy face of makeup. So that's what we're gonna do today. We're gonna chat, we're gonna have a good time. But before we get into the makeup portion of the video, I, for the last like almost 2 years, have been working with HelloFresh. They are a meal delivery service. They deliver meals directly to your door in an insulated box. In that box is either meals you chose, or if you didn't get to choose your meals, then they'll choose them for you. They are delicious. They're so fresh. It's got all the ingredients and everything is pre-packaged out for you in individual bags. And everything's in there that you need. So you've got your fresh veggies or meat if you choose one of those options. And then it comes with a recipe card. It has all the steps on the back of it that you need to create the recipe. Most meals for us take about a half hour to prepare, so you're not in the kitchen for hours and hours. They have something for everybody, so that includes low calorie, vegetarian, family friendly recipes every week. This week we chose the vegetarian box. We loved every single meal that was in it. I think I'm gonna keep going with the veggie box because honestly, they've been some of our favorite meals, and the meal that you see us make today, heaven help me if when I tell you, it's like top three favorite HelloFresh meals so far. The packaging that HelloFresh uses to ship your food in is made almost entirely from recyclable and or already recycled content. You can change your food delivery days, your food preferences. You can skip a week whenever you need to. Also, HelloFresh has donated over 2.5 million meals to charity in 2019 alone. And this year they're stepping up their food donations amid coronavirus. So that's amazing. This week we had the zucchini and tomato flatbreads. And like I said, they are absolutely amazing. The sauce that you make to put on the flatbread, I don't know how I've lived without this sauce. It is actually so good. And if you have the opportunity to get this meal, I highly, highly recommend you try it. Even if you're not vegetarian, which we aren't, but we have really tried to eat very veggie heavy meals. This one, hands down, like one of our favorite meals, so delicious. I'll absolutely be making it again. For me personally, I love that it takes the guesswork out of it. You don't have to think about what you're gonna make. You don't have to wonder, what are we having for dinner? You just pull out one of the bags and you've got everything you need right there.
I know it's good because I tried the sauce.
That's top three favorite HelloFresh meals so far.
I could tell it was going to be my ears just from the sauce. Even if you don't make this, you got to make the sauce.
This is so, 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 so good. The sauce, hands down, so good. Amazing.
It's very.
It's this. I'm going to go eat it now because I'm grumpy because I haven't eaten enough today. You guys can use code 60RAWBEAUTY and that will get you $60 off of your first 3 weeks, including free shipping on your first box with purchase. Just go to HelloFresh.com and enter the code 60RAWBEAUTY at checkout. And thank you again so much to HelloFresh for sponsoring the beginning portion of this video and for sending us the best meals. Okay, let's get into the makeup portion of this video. So what I have been doing is I'm using the Pure 4-in-1 foundation. You guys know, not much has changed, okay. But you can see I'm breaking out this whole pregnancy. I mean, I just don't know what to tell you. I always have a little bit of stuff going on, especially down here on my chin. I get hormonal acne anyway, so and it, like usually around my period or whatnot, I'll get pimples right here. So it's been the same this time around, but just for 9 months instead, so. But I've been really trying to keep it low on the foundation, so kind of spot doing it. So I have like veins right around here, a little underneath the eyes, and then just a little stripe on the forehead. I'm not like covering my entire face with foundation at all by any means. I already moisturized my face before I did my hair so that it had time to sink in. I used the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Cream. I really heavily coated it. I'm using a couple different colors here because the other one's a tad dark for me. I like to put a little extra down here too because I'm really red. That's about how much foundation. Now that may be a lot to some people. For me, this is kind of a little bit. Then I just take my brush. You can use a beauty blender, you can use whatever you have, but I've been using a brush because it's just so much faster for me. And because this is such good full coverage, it really doesn't take much to give you a very flawless coverage over your entire face, even with like a tiny little amount of foundation. You see that? I am not coating my entire face by any means. I also like it lately because I've been wearing, you know, a face mask every time I go out in public, and Washington actually just made it mandatory that you have to wear them every time you go out. So I don't feel like it gets all over the face mask or anything because I'm not overly wearing too much foundation at all. I have been using a little bit of powder lately just to kind of calm down the shininess in certain areas, but as you can see, there was such a small amount of foundation, I feel, on my face, and I feel like got really nice coverage. Man, I'm sweating my balls off. It's hot as hell up here. So now that my skin is, I feel like at the level that I like it, just nice and flawless, but not cakey with foundation at all. Ever since I did my Black Owned Makeup Brands video, I'm gonna link that video up here. I actually used the Fenty powder in that video and now I'm back on it again. I can't get enough. As far as concealer is concerned, I'm really not a huge concealer user. I know that the trend on YouTube is really to like cover the whole entire under eye, huge V's. I think that that's kind of becoming out of trend now. That's what I'm going with right now. And I'm just going to take the tiniest little amount right underneath the eye. This is the Fenty concealer. And take it up on my lid. Nothing cakey, nothing overkill, just a tiny little amount. Okay, now I'm gonna take a little bit of powder. The brush I'm gonna use for that, honestly, any brush is fine, but this is the one I'm gonna use. This is the Fenty 125 face brush. I'm gonna dip a little bit into that powder, and this is the butter powder. Tap off a lot of the excess on the back of my hand so there's nothing cakey, and just put it right on the under eyes and on the lid. Really not wanting to overdo it at all. Put it where I'm gonna throw the powder. That's kind of it. Simple, nothing overkill. And then this is the bronzer that I've been using lately. This is Fenty Shady Biz. Look how much I've used. Oh my gosh, can you guys even believe it? This is one of my favorite bronzers. I'm using the same brush for it. And I took it up the way that I normally do on the bridge of my nose here. Just trying to do my makeup the same way as I did in that video, because I had so many people be like, you're so glowy. Guys, makeup is a trickster. Makes you think it's a pregnancy glow. I promise you it is not. I wake up as dry, just crispy. And obviously I took a little bit on my forehead as well. I think I had faux freckles on that day too. I think, I'm pretty sure I did. I've been doing them almost every time I do my makeup. Just really like the way that they make everything look really sun-kissed and cute. You definitely skip that step if you're not a fan. So I'm gonna do my eyebrows real quick. I've been using exclusively the M Cosmetics brow products. This is the Fine Liner Brow Pencil in Brunette. Guys, it's so good. It's just such a good product. So easy to use, so simple. And I need to look in a mirror instead of my monitor, because that looks weird. But I like to just kind of fill the tail in. I'm not super careful on the end, but I like to like really line the bottom of it. My brows are the least important thing on my entire face. I literally couldn't care less, you guys, I couldn't. I do like a good brow product that's easy to use, and these are that for sure. Very simple, and I just, that's literally all I do. I just sort of brush up in the front here. That's brows, that's how fast they go. I just don't wanna spend any more time than I have to on this area of my face. There's nothing artistic, I feel like, about doing brows. I think I've talked about this before, but like, eyeshadow, there's something like satisfying about doing foundation, but then like to get to your eyebrows, it's like, oh my God, just be fucking eyebrows, you know, just be done. I wanna get them microbladed. I just honestly am a gigantic pussy. You guys wanna see this belly? Maybe some of you don't, but if you do, heaven help. You see that thing? Look at that. It's like, it's kind of fun. I kind of like being round. I'm round anyway, but did I finish my eyebrow? No. I am craving lasagna so hardcore right now that it's all I can think about. All that's on my mind as I sit here, I'm just like, oh, cheesy layers. crispy edge. Tell me that doesn't sound so good. You can't tell me because lasagna is the best food that exists. It's always my last meal. What is your guys' last meal? Like if you could pick one meal, is your last meal, the last meal you will ever eat in your life. Mine's for sure lasagna. Maybe that's just right now. But it almost always is. Glass bottle Coke. There's nothing better. Have you guys, if you haven't had glass bottle Coke, like if you're one of those people that are like, no, Coke in a plastic bottle or a can is fine. You need to have glass bottle. If you have never had it and you don't think it would be different, it's different, okay? It is completely different. It has such a good flavor that I could literally drink 500 of them over and over and over and over and over and over. Like I enjoy them so much. Ice cold from the fridge. For the eyes, I'm going to take just like a nice brown shade. Any shade shall do that you have. And I'm just running it right through the crease very lightly. Nothing overkill. I take it down on this part of the eye too. Honestly, the eyeshadow is right now, at least for this look, sort of not irrelevant. I mean, it matters, but any brown shade that you have will work. If you want it to be more cool toned, you can. I obviously really like these sort of mustardy warm browns. Any brush should work as long as it's fluffy and can fluff that color on right into the crease, down onto this part of the eye. Doesn't have to be like anything super specific. You can tell I'm not being specific about it. Like I'm just throwing it on. Bada bing, bada boom, that is the eyes. That's one eyeshadow color. Nothing crazy. And then I'm gonna take my lash curler, and I have been making sure to really curl my lashes. Still need to get a good eyelash curler. I'm just using the crummy little NYX one that I have, but it's what I have and it's what I'm using, so. Okay, so my last meal is gonna be a big, crunchy, amazing, like crispy edge, cheesy lasagna with like ricotta and just, oh. Okay, a glass bottle Coke, a banana cream pie, Marie Callender's banana cream pie, to be precise for my dessert. Ooh, cherry turnover, oh, stop. And don't stop. I have this thing for cherries, guys. Lemon too. You know what? Not lemon meringue pie though. Lemon meringue pie can get fucked. The lemon part, love. The meringue, ugh, get it out of here. It's like fluffy weird. It's too like, you can peel it all off in like one piece. You know what I mean? I'm not a fan. The lemon part, like those lemon pies, Hostess lemon pies or the Franz lemon pies, get it. They can get it. Crusty rustic sourdough garlic bread. There's something about Italian. I feel like it's the food I choose. I love all kinds of food, but there's something about Italian food that just gets me. Now I'm gonna use the CoverGirl Exhibitionist mascara, but I am using the waterproof version. This is the one that I have. Tell me what your favorite waterproof mascaras are that I can try. This is the one I've been using because I have it. I don't have very many waterproof mascaras. That's all I wear now because they hold your lashes so good, you guys. I'm serious. I know that I've said this before, but if you haven't tried waterproof mascara, it's the only way. It's the only way. It's the only thing that holds my lashes completely up all day long. If you want to avoid transfer with the CoverGirl Exhibitionist, you're going to have to tilt your head back because it's very wet formula, like extremely wet. You're going to want to tilt your head back because it transfers extremely easily before it dries. But oh, it transferred all under. You son of a. You can see how they just stand straight up. Like, dude, the waterproof mascara is the only ticket when it comes to the, well, curling, obviously, and waterproof mascara. It's just, I'm so surprised that it took me this long to try it. Can we talk about TikTok for a moment? That is an app I never thought in my entire life that I would frequent, okay? It just doesn't seem like something that I would like. TikTok is an app for me that I never go and click on. I never go, you know what? I'm gonna go to TikTok. I always like will see a TikTok somewhere like on Twitter or on Instagram, find it to be funny, and then I end up on TikTok. If it doesn't suck the soul out of my life, but I'm telling you, it's probably one of my favorite apps. I am so shocked by it. I only have 2 TikToks that I've ever uploaded, which is a travesty really, because I feel like that is the platform that people do so well on. The algorithm is absolutely amazing on TikTok. I don't even really care. I just enjoy watching it all day long. And the TikTok algorithm is so unbelievably correct with me. I don't know about you guys. It only shows me animals. And I love that. Because, I mean, sometimes these videos are so sad that I could literally cry 1,000 tears and do because I'm so unbelievably emotional right now. Just, I saw one today, this cat TikTok. It's like literally one of my favorite things I've ever seen. I'm gonna go show it to you guys right now and I want you to go. Hang on, shut up. I literally die. It's from Emily W0O. So Emily Wu, but one of those is a zero. And I am just gonna say it, like, it's like the most satisfying TikTok I've ever seen in my entire life. The fact that cat hits that note so perfectly, I die, and the cat is so adorable. That's the kind of TikToks I love. And the thing is that the algorithm knows me so well now that it only shows me TikToks like that, and it's amazing. Now, some of them will be like, you know exactly the TikTok song I'm talking about. I don't even have to sing it for you to know. Fucking tell me if when that song comes on with the cutest dog that you've ever seen in your entire life getting adopted after a life in a cage, like, it doesn't mess you up. And then, like, seeing all the sad dog TikToks and, like, all the rescue things, and so many of them have, like, a beautiful happy ending, but, like, there's this new trend, of course, on TikTok where people are throwing a ball. You see them, like, throwing a ball for their dog, and then, like, then they're throwing the ball and the dog's gone, and you're like, why would you do this to me? Like, why are you wanting to ruin everybody? Man, what an app. I never expected it to blow up the way it did, and the way they marketed, at first I was like, I don't think I'm ever gonna click on that. But when I found the right side of TikTok, like when it went from just the dances, which I couldn't be bothered to care about, from just the dances and stuff like that to animal content, I'm all about it. Okay, so as far as the glow goes, like I said in the beginning of this video, I used the Jaclyn Cosmetics highlighters when I did it the other day, and I used the Flash palette, and I kind of went in with, like, mostly this color right here, this one. I kind of mixed them up a little bit. You absolutely do not have to use this, though. Like I said, you can use, I mean, there's so many other things. You can just use whatever is your favorite highlighter, but this is what I used, and I dip kind of into all three of those, and then sort of run it right here on the apples of my cheeks and up. Mostly you use the color Iced. These definitely should not have been limited edition, in my opinion. They should have just stayed a permanent product, because this is not a limited edition looking product. You know what I mean? It's not the type of product that should be limited, because it's so a staple in a collection, you know? And the product is really, really good. You know, I wouldn't call them like Hourglass. I think initially when I did my first review of these, and if you guys haven't seen it, I did review it, but that video, I don't feel like got very good reception. And honestly, probably rightfully so, because I feel like I addressed too much in the beginning of it. Like, I went too in depth about the lipsticks, which, like, Chrissy, just shut up. I initially said that these powders were very similar to, like, Hourglass powders. And while I thought that they were similar, because packaging kind of reminds me similarly, the formula is extremely different. The Jaclyn highlighters are way, way, way glowier. These are more soft, ethereal, barely there. Whereas the Jaclyn ones are like, oh, they're there. But like I said, Ofra has really similar highlighters in the way that they're just like that blinding, beaming, beaming, beaming highlight. So if that's what you're looking for, and you can't get your hands on these, obviously, those work great. So I'm gonna do the Flower Beauty Brownstone real quick. I've been really into using browns on my eyes lately instead of going harsh with, like, black. Just feel like it's so much softer. Use a little bit of the blush from the Hourglass palette. Just a little bit on the cheeks. This is the It Cosmetics for brushes for Ulta, and this is the powder brush. It's really big and fluffy and soft, and I like the tapered shape of it. I love a tapered brush. And lip-wise, I actually have just been using the lip oil from Jouer. And as far as Wet n Wild is concerned, because I did talk about them in a recent video where I was talking about how, like, physician formula has been recently found to be selling in China, so they can't be considered cruelty-free anymore. People are like, well, what about Wet n Wild? I do still use Mochalicious, because Wet n Wild sent me, first of all, it's like my favorite lip color ever, but Wet n Wild sent me, like, over a year ago, like 15 of them, and I don't want to put them to waste, so I try not to, like, super promote, obviously, but I am still trying to use them up and, like, not be wasteful about it. So I'm gonna use the Jouer Essential Hydrating Lip Oil, which I've been using lately. Super glossy. And then actually for that video that I did wear a little bit of lip liner, and I actually used a Morphe one that I just had in the bathroom because it's in there. But I just took a little bit right up here to make my lips look a little fuller right up there towards the top. Right now I'm using the ColourPop little one. I love this liner. And I took it a little on the center here. And when I tell you, my friends, that is it. That is all I did. That is the makeup. This is the pregnancy glow makeup that everyone was like, you are glowing. And I'm like, But am I? You know what? I'm just gonna say, I do feel really beautiful. I feel pretty pregnant. I'm excited about that. I've heard that from other people. And again, right now I'm like almost 17 weeks, so I'm not even quite there yet. So I still have a ways to go. You guys have really seemed very extremely more receptive to all the videos than I thought, because this is a makeup channel. So I didn't know how you guys would, if you'd be excited to watch stuff like that or not. I know that I'm interested in it, so I like to watch videos like that. So if you guys are interested, I'm more than happy to. I hope that it doesn't seem alienating to some of my audience. But again, I said it in my Q&A video that I'm gonna post what I wanna post when I wanna post it, and I'm feeling like I might wanna do that. So I hope you guys like the video. If you guys did, please hit the thumbs up button and subscribe. I still can't even believe how many of you are watching. It makes me just, I'm just blown away. Thank you so much more than I could ever describe in words. And thank you again so much to HelloFresh for sponsoring the beginning portion of this video, for continuing to work with me and support my channel. And don't forget, you guys can enter the code 60RAWBEAUTY at checkout, and that will get you $60 off of your first 3 weeks and free shipping on your first box when you sign up with HelloFresh. And I thank you guys so much for watching. I just appreciate you more than I could ever, ever say. Hope you guys like the makeup. I mean, it's not anything crazy. I know I've done like makeup like this a few times, but it's just real. It's what I'm wearing right now. This has been my go-to. I have worn it. I'm not even exaggerating. Every time that I've done my makeup, this is exactly what I do. It's just simple, easy, and I feel really pretty. All right, you guys, well, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you at my next video. Bye! Is this recording? As I'm just sitting here Googling lasagna. And I've just been doing very minimal eye makeup lately. If you guys did not know, there's gonna be another truck in 3, 2, 1. Okay, you weren't as loud as I thought you were gonna be, thank you. If you don't know who HelloFresh is, they are a meal, If you don't know how to fresh. If you've never heard of HelloFresh, these cars are gonna be the fucking death of me, bro. Go, car, bitch. Go. On my brush. Wait, on what? On my brush. I'm also just randomly falling asleep all the time, and so I don't like the feeling of foundation on my face when I'm asleep. No, I'm not gonna go there. Just cut that out. Or whomever is editing this, it could be you editing it. Christy, who the fucking knows? Just trying to do my video the same way as I did my makeup. What? You definitely can skip that skip if you're. You can skip that skip! Have I ever spoken before? Because it's, ow! Lightning crotch. Ah! Wow. So Emily Wu, but one of those is.
Oh.
You absolute. All the way in and spin. Bitch, you did a terrible job.
Really? Because they're all falling into the oven.
Nothing's happening.
The world's worst knife. Literally.
Yeah, what else would you put it on first? Yeah, you put that and then you
garlic
put-
garlic is done. Evenly dop sauce, roasted garlic.
Evenly dop sauce.
Skeetily dop sauce.
If you don't put the cheese on, so help me God. Zachary, put it on. Stop!
It's fine, my hands are wet, so I guess.
My hands are wet!
My hands wet! This is the dullest knife, I'm so sorry. A little salt bay? A little chive bay?
Is that what they call you?
That's what they called me in high school, actually. Salt bay. No? Mm-hmm. Chive bay. Forgot my own joke.
Terrible joke.
Yep, chili bay.
The joke is dead. The joke is dead.
Dude, tell me. Nailed it.
Okay. I don't know what to do from here.
Bye.